My name is Serena Goose, and I am a junior athletic training major, pre-physical therapy emphasis from Roseau, Minnesota, and I play women's hockey. I guess my Bethel story is a little bit different than most students that go here. I didn't necessarily have any family members that went here, so most people when they come here, they're like, yeah, my mom and dad went here. They met here, they got married, like that's just kind of your typical Bethel story. That's not mine. Growing up, if you would have asked me, I would have said, I'm gonna go to the University of North Dakota or Concordia Moorhead and I'm gonna play hockey for them and I'm gonna be a Sioux or a Cobber, just like many of my family members did. So I went and toured those schools, and don't get me wrong, they're great schools, but something just seemed missing when I toured them. And so I kind of had two requirements of schools when I was touring, and that was a school where I could potentially play hockey at and a school where I would grow stronger in my faith and be challenged in my faith. And I definitely could have found that at those schools, but I just felt God pulling me somewhere else, and I didn't really know why. And so through a lot of prayers and tears, I guess, of trying to figure out where to go, I got a call from Coach Carlson with the Bethel Royals. And I didn't know a ton about the school. There were a few Roseau people that went there. I had a friend a year older than me that was on the hockey team, so I guess that might have been why he discovered me. And so he talked to me, I got to know him, and what I found unique about Coach Carlson is he didn't necessarily, I mean, he obviously was recruiting me from a hockey standpoint, but he didn't necessarily care about that as much. He was trying to get to know me as a person versus that was different from how other coaches were recruiting me. So I kind of found that unique and was like, you know, there's something that's up with this school that might, I don't know, God's pulling me in this direction. So I went out of my comfort zone and drove 6 hours to the Twin Cities with my parents and toured this school and found out after the tour, I was like, this is everything that I asked for in what I wanted in a school. So, and it's been that still. Oh man, if I had to describe my team in one word, I'm gonna use a classic family. I know that that's probably been used a ton, but this one just kind of hits more home to me. Coming 6 hours away, these people were some of the first people that I had met and ultimately some of my first friends. So my team is my family. They're people that I enjoy being around. I don't necessarily have to be best friends with them, but I love laughing in the locker room with them. I love the 2 hours that I get to spend with them each and every day. My favorite memories at Bethel are, I have one off-ice memory and one on-ice memory, I guess I could say. My favorite off-ice memory was last year we took a trip to Europe with our hockey team and we got to tour around Italy and Switzerland, and it was all during Christmas time, so it was just very surreal and all the events that were taking place. And I really enjoyed that experience. I guess my favorite on-ice memory would be from my freshman year when we were conference champions. My favorite game from that in the playoffs was the semifinal game when Hadley Cookson just went and sniped the Augsburg goalie, one of our big rivals. So it was just a great celebration and just fun times. I guess I have to be careful with my impression of Coach Carlson because he might ban me from Oreo cookies for probably the entire year if I do this wrong. So, let's see. When Coach is explaining drills to us or maybe coming in between periods, he can either be a man of a lot of words or very few words. So, there's one time where we were playing an important game and he's just so proud of us, but just didn't know what to say. So he's like, oh yeah, you guys are, you know, you guys are getting the pucks to the net, you're doing great, and it's whatever. And just walked out and we're like, what? And then, I don't know, Coach is just, he's such a goofball. Sometimes I feel like he gets kind of bored in his office, so he'll walk around and find us in our classrooms. And there's one time that I was sitting in the back of my class, of course, and he walks up to the door while the teacher's lecturing, in the middle of his lecture, and just comes up and waves at me, and the whole class turns around and then runs away. So that's kind of an everyday occurrence with Coach, but it's great. We love him, he's a goofball. I guess the legacy that I want to leave behind is more so for my team. Obviously, I want to be a championship team each and every year that I play here and even the years after, but more so I want to be a team that makes other teams at Bethel and other teams outside of Bethel ask, like, why are they the way that they are? What makes them so special? So whether that be how hard we work, just the kind of people we are, and just be people that will go out and just share God's love throughout whatever they do in the world.